does it matter if you wipe the rosin off your strings and off the instrument?
Yes. And that's another interesting point, is that the rosin, it's a lot of varnish is made out of rosin. If the violin has an oil varnish on it, an oil varnish is basically rosin or tree sap that's boiled down really, really hard, and then softened again with some more oil, and so.
No kidding, it's the same stuff.
Yeah, to a certain extent, and so what happens is you have this the chemical terms, but you have this pH attractiveness from the rosin to the varnish, that if it's not cleaned off, it becomes part of the varnish, and it sticks to the varnish, it gets harder and harder and harder to clean off, and actually embeds itself in the varnish.
Oh, yes.
So it's important to clean the instrument off. Again, if the first thing you want to do is wipe the strings off, get that buildup off the strings. If you have too much rosin buildup on the strings, again, you won't get a fresh, clean sound. And then the rosin on the strings is going to fall off onto the instrument, and then wipe the instrument off. If you do it after every time you play, or you know, if you keep a cleaning cloth in your case, so when you put the violin in the case, that just becomes a habit. You put the violin in the case, you wipe it down, it only takes, you know, 10, 15 seconds, and then it's done.
Do you have any suggestions for what type of cleaning cloth? Is an old t-shirt just fine?
An old t-shirt, flannel. I think flannel works the best. Old flannel nightgown. What I do here in the shop to clean instruments, we go to the fabric store and buy a bolt of flannel.
Oh, really?
Flannel, and we just cut it up, and you know, every couple of years we go buy another one. You don't, of course, we go through a lot of it, but for the average person, the important thing is that, is I see people in their case, and they have this cleaning rag that will almost stand up by itself because it's got so much rosin on it. Either, you know, if you have your cleaning cloth, eventually it's going to pick up the rosin, and once it's full, like your furnace filter or vacuum cleaner bag, it's just not going to pick up anymore. So,
is it okay to throw it in the laundry?
Yeah, sure. Put it in the laundry,
or
throw it away and buy another one. There are some, you know, special cloths made microfiber, and some have a cleaning additive put to it. I find those are fine, but again, you know, cotton flannel works wonders.
Okay, now what if I get a gunky buildup from my fingers on my fingerboard?
On the fingerboard, you can clean that with alcohol, rubbing alcohol. But again, you want to be very careful. If you're going to clean your fingerboard, what I do is take a paper towel and fold it over three or four times, put some alcohol on it, and squeeze it so that there's no way anything can drip off that cloth. And then you can go on your strings and underneath your strings and clean it. You do not want to get any alcohol on your violin. Drop
of washcloth under here.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea. Because the alcohol, again, is a solvent, and most all violin varnishes, you get a drop of alcohol on there, and it's going to start to eat the violin varnish. If you do drop alcohol on it, just leave it. Don't try to wipe it off, because you'll wipe the varnish off. If you get a drop on, just leave it.
Take it, Peter.
Yeah, but don't try to wipe it. But you can do that. You can clean the strings and the fingerboard that way.
Other miscellany. What if your pegs stick? Or they slip and your strings keep coming apart?
Right.
And sometimes you'll find that's a variable of the season, too. They made you just fine all winter, and all of a sudden in the summertime, your pegs are really sticky, or vice versa.
Right. That's a problem we have this time of year, where we're going back and forth from cold to hot. It may get really cold at night. And what happens is the pegs are generally...
We're in winter right now.
Yeah. the pegs are made out of a different material than the rest of the peg box, the neck, and so they expand and contract at different rates. And so sometimes you'll open up your violin case and one or two of the pegs have just gone completely loose.
Now you can cheat and buy those pegs that are like screws and they're mechanical.
Right.
But we're talking about old school, the real deal
right.
here.
And, you know, if the pegs stick, then you can, what we call peg dope, it's a lubricant that you can put on the pegs and makes them work smoother. However, if your pegs are slippery, don't put lubricant on it, because that'll make them slipperier still. Generally, if your pegs are slippery, it's because they don't fit properly. The hole that the peg goes into has to be the exact same taper as the taper on the peg. And so when that works, when that taper exactly matches the peg, everything should work properly. And that's another thing, it sounds simple, but it's a it's something that takes the experience of a violin repair person to really get that adjusted properly.
Now, if you have a concert and you can't get to the fiddle shop in time to get it adjusted, can you use something like chalk?
Yes.
As a stopgap
yes.
measure.
Yes. If it's right, you can put if it's slippery, you can put chalk on it. You can just take some.
Well, that's just a temporary measure.
It's really a temporary measure.
Yeah,
and
then your pegs
really
can go.
Solve the problem.
So it.
Right,
still
and so also the way the string is wound on the peg. If you wind, always wind the string towards the peg box wall, or towards the head of the peg, and that helps to pull the peg in tighter as you're winding it. There is a proper way to hold the violin also. You want to hold the violin by the neck and with your other hand hold on the chin rest and the metal parts or the button. Again, you want to touch the violin itself as little as possible. The violin, you don't want to be grabbing it like this or like this. Again, the oils from your hand, perspiration, all affects the varnish of the instrument.
Okay, now what about the famous rest position that we're all taught to hold the instrument in?
Right.
Like this.
Well, again, that's fine. Generally,
you've got a sleeve.
You've got a sleeve. Yeah, you're against. But you might on it if it's a,
if it's a hot
or humid day,
and you're
real sweaty, that may not be the best position. It may be better to hold it like this.
Okay.
Just depends. And I get people in all the time that, sometimes they'll have like a weird spot on their violin that it's like completely worn off, and which and when you talk to them, trying to figure out why that violin is worn or a cello in a certain area, and then
you watch him pick it up.
Eventually, you'll watch him pick it up, and you're holding it like this. Well,
busted.
This is going to get wear. Or you're holding it like this with your hand resting on here.
Oh, yeah.
Then this all wears off.
I bet you see that on a lot of symphony
right.
players.
And, especially people that are playing, 8-10 hours a day. Or the same way with a bow. This part of the bow wears or gets all corroded. And I'm like, how's that happen? Well, it happens. They hold it like this when they turn the page,
Oh, interesting.
so
is there a proper way to hold the bow?
Again, it's that a lot of people, when they're not playing, hold it like this, which is fine. But if it gets a little bit further and your skin then touches here, then you're going to get that oil and dirt, and it's all going to creep up the bow. So try to keep, when most people hold the bow like that, just try to keep as much of your hand away from the hair as possible.
What about holding the bow like that?
That's fine.
Yeah.
Anything like that is fine. You always want to protect the tip of the bow so it doesn't hit.
Yes, and that's why Peter put a metal tip on my
bow.
This
is the most fragile part of the bow.